show against The Undertaker. Undertaker watched his fight, but what is the condition of The Undertaker after last week's battle?
Undertaker with internal Cena. Injuries suffered in Vengeance and, of course, hurt again last week at the hands of John Cena. But look at the size of the two men in the ring. 500-pound Big Show, 300-pound Undertaker. One man 7 foot tall, the other man 6 foot 11, and they're going to lock up here tonight. Wow, there is the power of the Big Show.
That does not happen to the Undertaker often. Undertaker does not get locked up with a guy and get dropped on his back like that very often. I'm just trying to see if Undertaker is trying to favor his ribs, but I guess not. Whoa. Got out of the way there.
There's the quickness of the Undertaker. He will have the speed advantage in this matchup. You made a good point. We tried to talk to the Undertaker earlier today again about the ribs. Kept walking right by us. Didn't want to talk about it.
They got to stop trying to talk to the Undertaker.
Undertaker will go behind Big Show
Surprise.
Here.
If Undertaker had those long arms, he couldn't get his arms around that waist. Of a Big Show.
And a headbutt by the Big Show.
That's a lot of headbutting you took.
Big right hand by Big Show.
You can see the intensity on Big Show's face, man. Big Show came to fight, and Mr. McMahon probably fired up the Big Show.
Big Show, there's the elbow from the Undertaker to the side of the head. Make a good point. Big Show may have got his walking orders from Mr. McMahon moments ago.
Wobbling. Big man's wobbling.
Undertaker trying to knock the 7-footer down.
Careful.
Big Show not down yet.
Careful, dead man. Careful.
And he walked right into the big hand of the Big Show.
Undertaker might go for a run here, Cole.
Undertaker reversed it.
Hop-bar. Switch over. Look at this. Beautiful float over to that other. Fujiwara hop-bar right there by the dead man.
And I don't think I've ever seen the Big Show writhing in pain like that as he crawls to the rope to force the Undertaker to break the hold. Have you ever seen the Big Show in that type of position before?
I've seen Big Show get out wrestled by guys more technically sound than the Big Show, because Big Show relies on power. That was pretty impressive. Speed and armbar right there by Big Evil.
You like the strategy by Undertaker trying to take out the left arm of the Big Show?
Yeah, I mean, we've seen what happened last week to John Cena's arm, care of the Undertaker.
Big Show, after that big headbutt in control, whips Undertaker across the ring. Undertaker planting Big Show with a DDT. Into the cover, shoulders down, two, and Big Show kicks out.
That's the veteran instincts of the Undertaker. Hit a big, strong DDT, float right over quickly into that cover. No wasting around and dilly-dallying.
The veteran Undertaker seeing the opening here, looking to take advantage. A big boot to the side of the head of the Big Show. And Undertaker trying to seize every opportunity.
With that vintage leg drop, guaranteed by the Undertaker. Vintage leg drop!
Right across the back of the neck.
Undertaker's got that smash mouth style, baby. I love it. I dig it.
Undertaker taking the fight to the Big Show here on SmackDown. And there are the right hands.
Those big ham hocks right there. Those quick hands of the Undertaker. I'm surprised this strategy's working right here.
The big man, the Undertaker, going right to that left shoulder of the Big Show.
My point is that Big Show's got so much more body weight on him than the Undertaker's. Going old school here, though.
To the top rope, Undertaker.
Big time old school.
Across the shoulder. Trying to rip that shoulder out of joint.
Well, that'll do it.
And those direct shots, the right hand, right to that shoulder joint of the Big Show.
Undertaker on the move.
Look at this.
Uh-oh, side slam. Big time. 500 pounds landing on those ribs. And you hear the Undertaker in pain here.
When you see him grabbing at the ribs, remember the internal injuries. John Cena caused him to bleed from the mouth at Vengeance, and then again last week, the A-Train.
Well, last week, Undertaker hit a big, huge superplex on John Cena and hurt himself, Undertaker did. And John Cena went after those ribs, as is now the Big Show.
And don't forget the big backbreaker at the hands of A-Train last week.
Great point, great point.
He caused Undertaker to bleed from his insides again. And now Big Show is targeting those injured ribs, the big knees to the gut of the Undertaker.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Big Show's knees are the size of most people's heads, too. That man's got big legs, big arms, big everything. And I'm telling you, those body blows are going to take effect on Big Evil.
You know, Big Show had the Undertaker scattered. You knew he was just looking for the opening to go for the ribs. And Undertaker still with some fight in him.
Well, Big Show's getting a little cocky trying to poke out the dead man.
Another right hand by the Undertaker. And a third right. Undertaker moving a bit slower after Big Show went to the ribs, and there's a clothesline. And again, you see the Undertaker reaching for the gut area. Here's the cover. Hook to the leg by the Big Show. And Undertaker just got the shoulder up.
Don't think 500 pounds laying across your ribs helps the matter. And then the energy you got to exert by kicking out, as you were probably going to say, because I know how to read your mind.
An elbow to the back again, the kidney area of the Undertaker. Imagine the force of that elbow.
Hey, I've been in the ring with that big freaky mouth of the Big Show. I know the force of that elbow, man. He's an animal.
And look at this, the size 22, 5E boots, and 500 pounds being driven into those ribs of the Undertaker. That's like a small car being placed on his stomach.
People here in St. Louis ain't too crazy about the Big Show. I don't think Big Show gives a rat's ass, stomping right on those ribs again of the Undertaker.
And again, perhaps by marching orders of Mr. McMahon.